Hello everyone, let us today see the second technical term with the lens, that is radius of curvature. As we have understood center of curvature, once we understand them, these all terms and these all things will be easily understood, right? Here I have placed both the lens, that is this is convex lens and this is concave lens. What is the observation of this? Convex lens, both the curvatures are placed on each other. So you get a pointed edge for this. Okay, one single point edge you will get it. But concave lens are not like that, they are inverted. Okay, they are not joined on each other, they are inverted, simply inverted. The pointed edges are not jointed. Okay, so they have two different surfaces. So we point at surfaces, just see. So here both the surfaces are joined over here, that point we will take it as P. So the point P can be here or here, anything, it is the same, okay. But here these two, for concave lens, these two surfaces are not inclined on each other. Their faces are away from each other. So definitely there will be two different points, P1 and P2. Now we will understand what is radius of curvature. Okay, let us decide this point P. See here separately, I am drawing here like this. So the point P here we will consider. From point P to the center of curvature 1, the distance from point P to center of curvature 1 is itself is nothing but radius of curvature. As we know, convex lens is of two surfaces, so definitely there will be two center of curvatures. If there are two center of curvatures, then from point P to center of curvature 2 and point P to center of curvature 1, the distances are nothing but radius of curvature. So there are two radius of curvatures. Okay. Now if I come to this concave lens, okay, if I come to this concave lens, then it is having two surfaces because they are not mounted on each other. So definitely it will have two surfaces. So two points are seen, right? P1 and P2. So from P1 to C1, whatever is the distance, that is called as radius of curvature 1. And from P2 to C2, whatever is the distance, that distance is understood as radius of curvature 2. So in this way, both the lens are having two center of curvatures and two radius of curvatures. Okay, one more point you have to note over here, that is note. Okay. If these convex lens or concave lens, if they are equi-convex lens or equi-concave lens, equi means equal. In what sense they are equal? In their thickness, in their aperture, in their dimensions, if both the spherical curvatures are equal and they form a lens, then they are called as equi-convex lens. If they are equi-convex lens, the radius of curvature on this side and radius of curvature on that side will be equal. That means PC1 will be equal to PC2 when they are equi-convex lens. Okay, when they are equi-convex lens, then their radius of curvature will be equal. That means the distance of radius of curvature will be equal. It is applicable for this also, concave lens. If they are equi-convex concave lens, then P1, C1 will be equal to P2, C2. Have you understood this clearly? So this is all about radius of curvature. We finish center of curvature, we finish radius of curvature. Okay, in the next, we will understand about principle of axis. Now please see what is principle of axis. Principle of axis is nothing but the line joining both C1 and C2 is called as principal axis. And this line, principal axis, is an infinite line and it is an imaginary line. Because it is an imaginary line, it is infinite. Means you can extend it to any from this side and you can extend it to any distance from this side. Then what is the definition of principal axis? Principal axis is nothing but the line which joins both C1 and C2 is called as principal axis. As I said you, principal axis is infinite line and it is an imaginary line. So here also for concave lens, the line which is joining both C1 and C2 is called as principal axis. It is infinite. You can extend it to any extent on both the sides, and it is a imaginary line. Only identification of principal axis is that it joins both C1 and C2. Okay, it passes through C1 and C2 by joining both of them in both the lens. That particular line which joins both C1 and C2 and passes through it is called as principal axis of the lens. Okay, and it is an imaginary line and it is an extensible line. You can extend it to any extent. It is infinite. I hope you have understood all three terms related, that is center of curvature, radius of curvature and principal axis. Okay, thank you so much.